Hello everybody and welcome back to Tiny House Soap Company. Today we are going to be doing a video with an update on my Lithops. So I've gotten a lot of you guys that have requested a video about how my seedlings are doing and also how the little young adult plants that I got with my seedlings, how they're doing. So I'm going to go ahead and show them to you and we'll just flip over here. So here are my Lithops seedlings. And you can see that these two right here are actually starting to split, which is super duper exciting. And I've got all of these little babies here. I have only lost one baby Lithop out of this container. And I lost it, I don't know if it was due to overwatering or if there was something else going on, but it did not end up living. But I'm pretty excited by these guys, and so I am now watering these guys very infrequently. So whenever I first planted them, for the first month, I watered them every day. For the second month, I watered them every 2 days, and for the third month, I watered them every 3 days, and then so on and so forth, until about now. Until really I saw these guys splitting. And so once I saw these guys splitting, it really made me nervous to water them more frequently because I know that these guys here are just growing. They're using those old leaves to grow their new ones. And if I water them, then I definitely worry that that's going to make them not want to grow. So here are the other two. And of course, I ordered two packs of 25 seedlings, and this is what I got. It was the first time that I've ever grown these guys, so it doesn't bother me that I didn't get, 50 of them, So I certainly got less than 50 seedlings, but for the first time, the fact that I have two of them sprouting makes me pretty excited anyways. So these guys right here are doing really well, and I know some people will say that I should probably separate these guys right here because they're so close together, but I'm not going to. I don't plan on separating these, and I'm more afraid of them getting their roots getting damaged with me trying to separate them than I am with their roots becoming intertwined and those guys living with each other forever. I'm not really planning any big thing for these guys, so if they decide to grow together, then whenever they're too big for this pot, I'll go ahead and transfer them over to a bigger pot and they can all go together, and that's fine with me. What I have been using to keep these guys light, other than the light that naturally comes in here, is this guy here. And you guys know that I recommended that whenever I first ordered these guys, I ordered this light and these guys at the same time. And it's worked really well. I do have it on a timer so that it is automatically set to come on. And it has both a low function and a bright function. And I have mine set on the bright function. And then the other thing I have here is my water bottle. And I just generally, typically I use the just regular tap water to water these guys. But I have also used this product here, this Tap and Roots product, and that has been worked really well. I started using this honestly when I started having issues with my other Lithops, which I'll show you in a minute and you'll be able to tell. And so I mixed like a quarter of a teaspoon in an entire gallon jug of water. And what I've been doing is I will take this and I will fill it up and I will use this to water all of my plants until it's empty. And then the next time I'll fill it up with just regular water. And I'll do that several times. I'll do just regular water a couple of times and then I'll do the tap and roots and then I'll go back to this. And so I don't know if that's part of the reason why these guys have grown well, but that tap and roots product is supposed to really produce more root growth than just regular water. It's supposed to enhance their root growth, and it seems to have worked pretty well. So at least mine are still alive right now, so that's good. And then, sorry, there's my cat. Over here is my other Lithops. And you'll see I have a lot of other plants as well over here in various stages of doing okay or not. So these are my other Lithops, you guys will remember, that I planted. And as you can see, this guy right here is not doing so good. So he did not ever take to, he never started, his roots never really grew, is what happened. So I didn't realize anything was wrong with him until my cat came over here. When they first were here, she was investigating them and she thought they were toys. So she was batting them and it fell over, and this guy was hanging out in there totally fine, and this guy had fallen out. And I was like, that seems a little bit weird. And the roots were not really attached to anything. So that's when I first realized that there was a problem. Yes, I have left him in there. And you can see he's like shriveling up and not doing so hot. But I just left him in there because I didn't really want to, I wanted to see what he did. I didn't want to give up on him too soon in the event that it worked. And so that's when I started using the tap and roots roots, and it has not really worked for him. I did feel like this guy back here, he was pretty shriveled at one point and looked like he was heading in the same direction as this guy. And I thought, oh crap, I'm going to lose a second one. But I started using it. I did a little watering of tap and roots, and I only watered in this area over here. I didn't water these guys because they seemed really healthy and doing fine. I didn't want to cause them to rupture. So I just watered over here. And after like probably a month or so, he started showing some life again. And now he's this beautiful, full little Lithop, and I love it. So this guy here is a little bit etiolated, either way, meaning that he's kind of grown a little bit tall. And originally when I first planted both of these guys, or all of these guys, I just had them in this pot. I didn't have any lighting over here. And so what I found was that if I used this, I went ahead and bought this lamp right here, and it's a pretty lamp. I got it off of Amazon. It has a 3, 6, and 12 hour function, and it worked really, really great for these guys. And I feel like it's helped them not become so etiolated or grown so tall. And I also think that since I've been using it, more of the crevice here is starting to pop up. So that's pretty exciting to me. So this is going towards the dormant time of their life cycle. Or I think it's the growing, I can't remember. I'll look it up and I'll post about it below. But they are actually going to start growing. Their new baby leaves are going to start coming out here towards the end of winter time. And so I'm pretty excited that they're starting to have those little cracks there, because I feel like that means they're making some progress. This lamp here, other than having great functions for the three, and I have this set to go for 3 hours at a time, I do not feel like this lamp is as bright as the other lamp that I have for my little baby Lithops. So that's something that, you know, if you're looking for a really bright lamp, I probably wouldn't use it. And then just for you guys' information, I have a little jade plant here, which is loving this light. This is also a jade plant, but it's kind of one of those that's more of a vine type one. And then I've got a couple other little succulents. These guys are not doing so hot. I think they don't like as much water as they are getting. So, but the other plants really need more water. And you can tell because this guy right here has got all of these little hair-like roots, and that means he needs more water. So I've been having to water a little bit more just to keep him. This sand mix is not the same as the mix that I've used for my Lithops. You can see this is a lot more rocky than the other ones. So that is pretty much it. And I'll show you guys this again. And oh, I'll just go over watering because I haven't watered these guys in a little bit. And so when I do water them, I take my little squeegee bottle here and I'll just take it and very lightly just go over this. So it's not a lot of water that I put in there. I am trying to stay away from these guys, but it's a little bit difficult. And then the same thing here for these guys. Here, let me focus the camera here. So I'll just do a little overlay just like that. So it's really not a lot of water that I'm using. So that is, and that's essentially how I watered them whenever I was watering them every day. I would water them like that when I went to every other day. And so now that I'm just watering intermittently, that's all the water that I give them. And I do feel like if you're giving them a little less water, then you're going to be a lot safer than if you do a lot of water. So the only other thing was some people were concerned about their mixture of soil. And I'll just show you, this is the mixture of soil that I have. And it's pretty rocky. It's pretty gravelly. So they have a lot of perlite in here. So just make sure you have a good draining soil. I bought this with these seedlings that I bought, and you can see they've done really well. And this one right here, I did put some sand, whereas in these two, I did not put sand in them, and you can see the difference. I do, in that I feel like there's a lot more sort of like greenish mold or whatever that's growing in there, I'm not sure. Whereas I don't feel like there's as much in this one. So that's been my update, and I hope that you guys have enjoyed it. If you have any questions, then please let me know. Otherwise, we will end this video from here. Thanks.